What if I told you there was a way for whoever creates the presentations for ProPresenter to communicate with the operator? And no, I don't mean labels. Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, ways that ProPresenter creators can communicate with the operators. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach you all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And if you've ever wanted to put in a note that's really, really obvious, go ahead, give me a like, thumbs up, etc. So this is something that I've had a couple of people ask about. And so I thought that I would make a tutorial because there are a couple of little features inside of ProPresenter that not a lot of people are taking advantage of that can make this work really, really well. So let's head over to the computer and we will take a look. So here we are in ProPresenter, and let's say that I'm in, I don't know, this song. And right here, I have a note that says interlude for four measures. That's what 4M means. But what if what I wanted to do was I wanted that to be a little more obvious, you know, because you could be going along and just not be paying attention to this. What if you could put like a big old note right there, right in the center? Well, you can. So let me show you what you might do. Of course you can do this. So let me show you how I did that just in case that's all you wanted to do. So if you right click on it, go down to label, hide myself real quick, and select edit, you can put in whatever you want and you can change the color of it. So, you know, I could make it like that color and, you know, four measures. So I could do that. That would work. But I want it more obvious than that even. But I don't want it to be something that would show on the audience screen. So here's what I'm going to do. Right click, select edit slide. I can also click on edit right here. Does the exact same thing. But I usually do right click and then edit slide. So I've got this text box here. And I'm just going to type in the message that I want. So, interlude for measures. Now, that's fine, but I can do better than that. So, first thing I'm going to do is let's go into scaling and change this from none to text up or down. And that will make it either, depending on how much you have in there, it will scale it down so that it fits within here, or it'll scale it up so that it takes up the entire space. So notice I only had the three words, so, well, two words and a number. So that's how it did that. So that's good. But if we go here and I click on it, notice it's shown on the audience screen, so that's no good. So how can I make it so that it doesn't show on the audience screen but does still show here? Well, let's right click and go back to edit, and if I click on this and then here under shape, there's this checkbox visibility. I can select all of the following conditions are met or any of the following conditions are met, doesn't matter which, and choose type. Let's select this particular object, and so right now it is showing it if it has text. I don't want it to show, so I'm going to show it only if it doesn't have text. So let me show you what happens when I do that. So I go back here, click on the exact same slide, and it doesn't show on the audience screen, which is perfect. Because I didn't want it to. You can see I've done this exact same thing a little later, but that's the idea. Now, there is a downside to this. Although, for this particular note, this might not be a downside. The downside is if I go to my stage screen, notice that on the stage screen, it shows that. So how could I get around that as a problem? Well, let's take a look at one of these others right here. And I'm going to edit the slide. And notice the default text object name is text with a capital T. So what happens if I go into screens and then edit layouts here? There's a couple of other ways to do that. But what if I did the current slide match element name choice here instead? So this is one that I've already created. So let me just show you how to do that. So let's go with the current and next text here. And I'm going to click on that, go to text, and let me hide myself again real quick where it says current slide and text. Let's instead select match element name. And for match element name, let's call it capital T E X T. So that's the default text box name. So that's good. And let's do the exact same thing down here. Next slide and match element name and capital T E X T. So even though it's set to match element name, as long as you haven't changed the name of the text box from the default, then it should work. So let's change to that one, which was this one right here. And notice that here, that actually isn't the right one. Silly me. Yes. So let's make sure that that is correct, because I would expect, that's this one. Sorry. This is the one that I would need to make sure anytime I was using this trick that the text box was not using the default name. So let's right click and edit this. And see, it is using the regular name, so I'm just going to rename it to anything else. I could even put space 1 after it, just to show you. So if we go back here, and see, notice nothing. So that was the only thing, is anytime you're using this trick, if you don't want it to show, change that text box name to anything other than the default, which is capital T, lowercase EXT, and that's it. So change it to anything other than that, and it won't show. Leave it as is, and it will show. And you could even change the color to make it a little bit more obvious, but both of these are using that visibility option to make it kind of really, really obvious that this is a note that is not going on the stage screen and is going to be visible to the operator, but not visible to the congregation. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter Quick Start course, so head on over to TDM.fyi/ProQuick. Give me your name and email address, and I will make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.